Let's see security in Microsoft Dynamics AX 2012 in a theoretical way. And by security in AX 2012 is quite a huge topic, but we'll not go so deep on it. We'll just take a look on a high level overview of and what is relevant to our current project. We'll not go so deep and we'll just take a look on what is relevant to our current project. And let's go see in a theoretical way what is security in Microsoft Dynamics AX 2012. So the security policies are a set of security rules that control our working environment. So which means is the security policies are just a set of security rules. And the security rules are just a job scope of every person. Like let's say in our organization, we have a role of our CEO and role for our account manager, a role for our sales manager and purchasing manager. So we have a different type of security role. And by this security policies, we define that each of these role have their own job scope. Let's say accounting manager will have their own job scope and sales manager will have their own job scope. So you cannot expect that as an accounting manager will also do the job of a purchasing manager, or sales manager, or even of the job of the CEO. So that is not going to happen. So by this set of security role, we control our working environment. And let's see the security roles. These represent the scope of work of every person in our organization. So which means that security roles is a job scope for each and every person in our organization. We have a lot of employees in our organization and each employee has their own job scope. So that is our security role. And the duties, these are the responsibilities that they perform tasks for a specific business objective and process cycle, and they contain a set of application process privilege. So after second rule, when we have a certain job scope, we also have a duty. So each job scope has their own duties. So for the sales manager, he is going to check on the sales order, he's going to visit the customer. He have a lot of duties. Each of the this security role have their own duties. So these are what we call as the duties in AX 2012. So and they are linked with a certain permission. So each duties have their own privilege, whether they are allowed to do or they are allowed to do or not allowed to do. So these are the two things that the duties will have. And the privilege and the permission, these are the group of access right granted to a user. So in the privilege, what we give is we give access to certain things and we don't give access to certain things. Like let's say for a sales manager, we give him access to all of the customer list and also a sales order on creating sales order and checking all of the invoice, right? So we give a certain privilege. So he may not be able to access our vendor list and he may not be access other things that is related, not related to his job scope. So with a privilege, we can set a permission whether he is allowed to access certain things or not, is allowed to access or not allowed to access. So that's how it's security is in Microsoft Dynamics AX 2012 in a high level overview. And hope you guys have a basic understanding now and what actually all of these are. So I will see in the next video. Till then, have a great day.